Hello everyone, this time we are going to learn more about SQL, and the SQL we are going to learn is SQL joins. Okay, SQL joins is done on two or more tables. When we want to fetch data from more than one table by combining those tables, making relationship between those tables on some common field. For that purpose, this SQL joins can be used. The process or function of combining data from multiple tables is called a join. Okay. See, first we are going to know how many types of SQL joins are there. And SQL join clause is used to combine two or more tables based on a common field between them. Okay, while querying for a join, more than one table is considered in from clause. First and foremost thing is that join clause is used to combine rows from two or more tables, and these two or more tables must have a common field. Okay, must have a common field between them. On that common field, we will join both the tables. While querying a join, more than one table is considered in the from clause. So all the table names is to be given in from clause. SQL can extract data from two or even more than two related tables by performing either a physical or virtual join on the tables using where clause. Okay, so to make joins between two or more tables, we have to do one thing, that all the tables must be given in from clause, and there should be a common field in both the tables, all the tables. Okay, and we have to use where clause also to provide some condition, okay, to provide some common values like this. So the types of SQL joins in SQL is like this. There are total of five joins. First is known as Cartesian product. Okay. Next is equi-join, then self-join, then non-equi-join, and natural join. Now we are going to learn these joins one by one, and we also try to do practicals on them. Okay, so that we can understand it in a better way. Let's see. First, we are going to understand Cartesian product or cross product. What is this? Cartesian product is also termed as cross product or cross join. It is a binary operation and is denoted by X. The degree of the new relation formed is the sum of the degrees of the two relation. Degree means the total number of columns. So in the resultant, when we perform Cartesian product on two tables, then the product in the product or the in the resultant table, the degree of the resultant table must be the sum of all the relations, all the degree of the relations, the degree of the two relations. Means if there are two columns in first table and three columns in second table, then in the resultant table there should be five columns. Okay, this is the way of Cartesian product. Next is the number of tuples in new relation is equal to the product of the number of tuples of the two tables. Means if their tuples means rows. Okay, if there are three tuples in first column, first relation, first table, and two rows or two tuples in second table, then in the product, in the resultant table, there should be 3 × 2, 6 rows must be there. Okay, so degree means the number of columns is summed, added, and the number of rows is multiplied between the two columns. Okay, see example here. We are having two tables, student table and games table here. Okay, student table is having three rows and two columns, and This games table is having two columns and two rows. Then we are doing some what? Cartesian product. Then in between the two tables, the statement will be like this: select name, gname, then from, and all the table names will be given in the from clause. There should be order by clause. Okay, order by, so that arrangement must be there. Okay, so order by clause is given here, and then see the product resultant table is containing all the six rows. Okay, six rows means three rows is in the first table and two rows in the second table. These two are multiplies, 3 into 2 = 6. So the resultant table is having the six rows. Okay, now you see here only two columns is displayed here, because we have mentioned here the two column names. Okay, name and gname. Suppose if we have given a star here to display all the columns, then all the columns will be displayed, means 2 + 2 = 4 columns will be displayed in the resultant column. Let's see the example. We have opened MySQL command client, and then we are going to open database. First and foremost command is to give what? Use, and database name is school. And then we have to check that which table is created. Show tables command can be given, and all the tables is like this. We have to perform Cartesian product between two tables, that is the student table and games table. Okay, see, one by one we are going to learn these things. See, first we will see that how many columns are there. Select star from the student table. So here are roll number, one column is there, and two column, name column is there, and then four rows is there. And then what is how many tuples are there in games games table? See, only two columns are there. Okay, now we are going to perform Cartesian product. Then Cartesian product, how can we do? Then select star from table names we have to give. Okay, that is a student comma games. Okay, and then we can give order by clause, order by g name. Okay, games names, and then semicolon. Here, see what happened. In first table, two column is there. In the second column, two column again is there. So four columns is displayed here. Okay, and the rows, four rows in first column, first table, and two rows in second column. So total 8 rows is created here. Multiplied product is there. This is done. Okay, as per the statement here, we can give like this statement also. Select gname, select name comma gname, okay, from student comma, then games table, and order by gname. Okay, this command is given here, and see the result is like this. Okay, understood? This is the Cartesian product. Now next, equi-join. An equi-join is a simple SQL join condition that uses the equal to sign in where clause as a comparison operator for defining a relationship between two tables on the basis of a common field. So this is the syntax for doing a equi-join between two tables, two or more tables. And this is see here, select command we have to give, then column names we have to give, then in from we have to mention all the table names separated by comma, and in where clause we have to make a condition, equal to condition, between the common column. So to do equi join, we all the tables we are going to join must have a common field. Okay, both table must contain one common field. So in where clause we have to give that common column names with the names of table names. Okay, See, example. See, this is, suppose this is the student table which we have created here. Okay, and this is the fees table. These two tables, and on these two tables we are doing equijoin. Okay, see here, this is the roll number. Okay, and again roll number is there in the second table. So the here is the common field. This is the common field in both the table. So now if there is common field between two tables, then only we can do equijoin between these two tables. See the command here, we have to write the commands like this. Okay, select roll number, name, comma, fee from table student and fees. We have to give the table name in the from clause. See here, we have added some additional letters A, B like this, A, B like this. Okay, actually what happened, this is the alias name of the table name. Okay, this is the alias. A is given for table name student and B is given for table name fees, so that we can, in place of table name, we can use the alias name, and it makes the query shorter. Okay, it makes the query shorter so that easily it can be easily understood and it can be seen within one screen like this. Okay, so we have given here A dot roll number. Actually roll number is common in both the table, so we have to mention from which table we have to display the roll number. So we have mentioned here A means from student table roll number will be displayed, and name is not common, fees is not common, so we need not to give alias name before the column name. Okay, it can be recognized automatically. Actually MySQL, what happened in MySQL, there becomes a confusion that from which table we have to take common field, so we have to mention that table name before the column name. See here what we have given command, roll number is to be displayed from student table, and name from, again from student table, and fees from next fees table. Okay, so we have mentioned in from all the tables here with the alias name A and B. And in where clause, this is the most important thing here. In the where clause, we have to mention the common field from both the table. A from student table roll number and B from fees table roll number. And there is an equal to sign. It indicates that it is equijoin condition. Okay. So see, when we have given this command, and it will execute it, it will display this resultant table. Okay, what is the resultant table? It will display the common fields which match with between both the tables, and the values will be like this. Okay, name from student table and fees from fees table, and both are combined according to the roll number in the common column, common field. Let's see in the practicals also. Okay, first see that student table is there or not. Is select star from student. Okay, yes, student table is there, four columns, and then select star from fees table. We have these values. Okay, and then there is a common field, and then we have to give command like this: A dot roll number, then comma name, comma fee from all the K table name student, and alias name A, and then fees, alias name B. Okay, and then we have to give where condition A dot roll number equals to B dot roll number, means when the roll number matched between two tables, then only rows will be displayed. So this is the answer for your query. Okay, both the tables will be displayed like this. Understood? One column is not matched. Which one? Rohan. Actually, Rohan, the field name, roll number 1 is not present in the second column. So, Rohan is not displayed in the resultant table because it does not match between these. Only the common rows will be displayed here with the values. Next is inner join. Inner join is a variation classification of equijoin, and it is same as equijoin. Okay, where either of the equivalent queries gives the intersection of two tables. Intersection means the common field. Common values will be displayed from both the tables. It returns the rows which are common in both the tables, as we see in the previous example. Then the command will be same: select student roll number, name, fees from student, fees and student dot roll number equals to fees dot roll number, order by student dot roll number. See here we have not used alias name, then we have to mention each time this table name. Okay, student table name, fees table name, like this we have to mention. Okay, if we want to shorten this with the alias name, then we can use like this. We have given A and B alias name, and that A is given with the roll number, and here in where clause we have used as like this. Okay, so if we want to order, if we want to sort the result, then we can use order by clause. See the example what happened when we use order by clause. This is the command we have given. Okay, then remove the semicolon and then give order by A dot, sorry, order by fees, fee. Okay, semicolon. Now what happened? Order by fee is displayed accordingly in ascending order. If you want to see in descending order, then we have to give command like this. Either we have to add DESC, then this as in descending order it's displaying. The largest one is displayed at the first. This is inner join. Next is outer join. Outer join is like this. The outer join keyword returns all the rows from the right table, from the right table, table 2, with the matching rows in the left table, table 1. The result is null in the left side when there is no match. If no match is there, then null will be displayed, means no empty set will be displayed. This is the command like this. Okay, see here, fees is displayed in descending order, and we have to write the outer join command like this. Union is a joining command which is used to join values or rows from two tables. There is a requirements that both the tables are having same number of columns, okay, common columns. They are only that way we can use union value, okay, union operator. See here, the union operator is used to combine the result set of two or more select statements. The union operation is used to return all the distinct rows selected by either query. For executing union between two tables, the number of columns selected from each table should be the same. Okay, should be the same. The number of columns selected from each table should be the same. Also, the data types of the corresponding columns selected from each table should also be same. Okay, it means that in both the table the name and data type of the column should be same, then only we can perform this union between these two tables. See here, example, we have created two tables like this. One is boy and next one is girl. Okay, girl table. And both the table is having same number of columns. Roll number name, okay, with the same name, same data type, same value, okay, but different values. And roll number of name with the same number of columns in next table, and data type must be same, but values may be different. And then we have given the command like this. Okay, select roll number name from boys. Union, select roll number name from girls, then order by name we have given, so that list will be displayed in ordered way. And see the result here. The result table will show the data from both the table, combined and added, both the table in like this. You can see in example also. if you want to see. See here, suppose first we want to see that tables are already created or not. Yes, there is a girls table and boys table. So one by one we are going to see that how many rows are there from boys. Okay, three rows are there, and then select star from girls. Okay, two rows are there. Now we are using and also we want to see that data types are same or not. Then we can use describe command, describe boys. Okay, so see, roll number is int type, integer type, and name is varchar 15, and then describe girls. Then see, here again roll number is integer type and name is varchar 15, so data type is also same here. Then only we can perform union operator between these two tables. How we can do that is, just we have to give select command, select name, roll number first, roll number, then comma name from boys, and then in between union you have to give, and then select roll number comma name from girls. If you want to arrange data in some alphabetical order, you can give order by then name. Okay, name key accordingly. Then we have to give enter, we have to press enter key after giving semicolon, and then result will be shown from both the tables like this in arranged order, in alphabetically arranged according to the name. This is the result. Okay, now next, some practical implementation on SQL joins. Okay, we have come to know more about SQL joins, so we will take more examples and we will practice it more so that it will be understood us to us in better way. So we are using two tables here, that is table vehicle table with five rows, okay, and travel table with again six rows, and number of columns is like this, six number of columns and six rows, and here three number of columns and three rows. Some names are like this. See here, code is named. In vehicle table you will see code V type and per kilometer like this. And what are these things? See here, per kilometer means freight charge per kilometer. What is the charges for per kilometer for vehicle, each type of vehicle, and V type is the vehicle type. And in travel table, see here, NO number is the traveler number, the person number who want to travel, and then KM is the kilometer travel, how many kilometers is traveled. Okay, and then NOP is number of travelers in the vehicle. In the vehicle, NOP, this NOP is the number of traveler, number of passengers in particular, okay, in particular vehicle. Okay, and then T date is the travel date of the travel. Okay, this is the code of the code is given, the vehicle code number is given here, and this is the number, means the person's number is there given. Okay, accordingly these two tables are there, and we want to do some practicals on these two tables based on these two tables. See here, first query is that to display number, name, travel date from the table travel in descending order of number. Then this is the command here, select number, name, T date from travel, order by number in descending. Okay, if you want to see it practically, we have created both the tables, and we want to show you this in practical way. See here, first we want to see all the tables. Okay, show tables that we have created tables or not. Here see, travel table is there and vehicle table is there. Now one by one we want to see all the values from these tables. So travel table is containing all these values, and then vehicle table is containing these values. So if we want to perform that first query to display number, name, T date, okay, from travel table, order descending order, so this is the command, number, name, travel date. Okay, number name travel date. Select number name comma t date from travel. Okay, from travel, then order by number in DSC descending. So this is the result. From travel table, it is displayed only these much values. Next query is like this: to display the name of all the travelers from the table travel who are traveling by vehicle code number 101 and 102. So this is the command. It can be given like this: select name from travel where code equals to 101 or code 102. See, code is given within single quotation mark. It can be given like this. However, the code is integer type, but we can give in single quotation mark. It is acceptable. Next command, we can give the same command without a single quotation mark. It is also acceptable. See the example. Okay, select name from travel where code equals to 101 or code equals to 102. Okay, see the example. So these very passengers are using these vehicles, which are code number is 101 and 102. These three passengers are using this query. Okay, answer comes. Now next query is like this: to display the number and name of those travelers from the table travel who traveled from 2015 12/31, means 31st of December 2015 to 1st of April 2016, in between these two dates, okay, which travelers have traveled? Okay, which travel has traveled? So the command is like this: select number name from travel where t date, traveling date, is greater than equals to like this, and travel date is less than equals to like this. This command can also be given using between operator like this: select a number name from travel where travel date between these very dates and these very dates. You can give like this. See here example. Okay, 2031st December 2015 to 1st April 2016. Okay, so command is like this: select number comma name from travel where t date between within single quotation you have to give date 2015 12/31 and 2016 4/1, like this. See how many passengers? Yes, only two passengers used or traveled between these two dates. Okay, this is the answer. You can try it yourself also. Okay, now next question: to display the code name vehicle type from both the tables with distance traveled in kilometer less than 90 km, means we have to display code name and type, vehicle type also, and code also, and name also. Okay, code, name, and vehicle type from both the tables. Okay, see here, both the tables we are using here. So equijoined we have to use here: with distance travel kilometer less than 90 km. So equijoined we have to use. Both the table is having common field. See, you can see here that there is a common field, code field is there, and also it is having the code field. Then on these both common field we can use equijoined. So both the table can be used and this query can be applied. How it can be applied? Select a code. Here code is given from travel table. Okay, so a alias we have used, a code comma name comma vehicle type from both the tables travel and vehicle. The alias name is given A and B, and then where A code equals to B code and kilometer is less than 90. Command is given like this. Okay, so we are using this command. If you want to know the code and name and vehicle type, then we have to apply this query and then we can see the result. See, select A dot code comma name comma V type vehicle type, then from travel A and vehicle B, where A dot code equals to B dot code and kilometer is less than 90, semicolon, kilometer is less than 90. See the answer. Yes, two persons have used this very type of vehicle who have traveled less than 90 kilometer. Okay, Ahmed Khan and Ravina, these two. Understood? So one last query is also there. To display the name and amount to be paid for vehicle code 105, means amount we have to calculate. Okay, if 105 vehicle is used and the name of the person who have used this vehicle, amount to be paid is calculated as the product of kilometer into per kilometer freight. Okay, so we have to multiply these two values for this vehicle and name is to be displayed. So in the select statement we have to use name comma name, then kilometer into per kilometer we have to multiply anyway, so that amount will come. Okay, and we have to use both the table, travel and vehicle table, so that we can obtain 105 code and name and amount also. Both the table we have to use, and then if we are using both the table, we have to use equijoin. So equijoin, based on the common field, we have to use equal to operator and we have to give that A code must be 105. So the command is like this. If you want to see the result, then result will be obtained by executing this statement, and this statement is executed like this. Select name comma kilometer multiplied by per kilometer from vehicle from travel comma A vehicle comma B, where A dot code equals to B dot code and A dot code equals to 105, vehicle should be 105. Then this is the answer. The person is Ravina and the total amount is to be paid is 3200. This is the answer we have got. So we have used both the tables, we have done equijoins also, and several other commands we have used, these practicals we have seen. So we hope that you have understand it well, how we can do joins, different types of joins. And then so we have given you some exercise which you have to do it yourself. This is a very exercise you have to do. Okay, try to do. And thank you, hope you understand the topic well.